Whereas the knowledge base, it's almost like a one way, right? Through practicals, you always have the unknown endpoint because you will be learning completely new. To be honest, like I'll tell you, like I didn't like education much. Like very high standard science research, basic research we do in the laboratory. Practice entrepreneurship to take these technologies, convert them into a product to reach to the people.
Hi all, I'm very excited here to interview a very famous scientist who holds a PhD degree from Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. He has a postdoc from City University of New York and Harvard Medical School. I'm very excited to talk to him about STEAM education and its importance. He's presently working as scientist at inStem, Bangalore. We welcome Dr. Praveen.
Thank you, Mr. Santosh, for having me.
Sir, there has been a constant debate in terms of knowledge versus hands-on experience. So according to you, how do you think knowledge versus hands-on experience are both important for the development of individuals and development of the nation?
Absolutely. I think as you said, like these two parts are very integral part of learning. As in, both knowledge and practical base gives a full training or full learning basis. Because what I see is like knowledge is something like it's absorbable, information that is provided to, right? So that has been acquired from somewhere else and given to you, presented in a manner that you can memorize and understand. But whereas the practicals gives the active learning process where you can apply your thoughts while learning so. And you know, you keep refining your thought process to learn more, learn better. Because whereas the knowledge base, it's almost like a one way, right? What is being given to you, you are reading and absorbing and understanding and memorizing. But whereas in the practicals, it gives you like your given set of information, but by applying that, then you will see like you start putting your own thoughts into it and see, start asking questions, why and why not? And you keep evolving and you refine your learning process. In another difference, what you see is knowledge based, you know end of that like what exactly you're learning, the end point you know. But in the through practicals, you always have the unknown end point because you will be learning completely new,
right,
which you have not started with.
True.
I think these two aspects are absolutely important to if you want to become a person having the complete knowledge together.
Right. So in other terms, what I understand is you're saying that the knowledge is like something like absorption, whereas doing practical is something like filtering things out and trying to ask things to make sure that both are going in hand and on.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Okay.
In fact, like the practical is something you're also putting your input into it.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And then asking questions like, you know, can it be done only this manner?
Mm-hmm.
If you do change this, what will happen?
Mm-hmm.
That's the curiosity. You're automatically, you're forcing a person to show their curiosity and see how things evolve. Just to give an example, a simple example, right? Say I'm a chemist, so I tend to give a lot more chemistry examples,
right?
For example, like when you read about a chemical reaction, so teacher tells you like, you know, take reagent A, take reagent B, and you mix together, you'll get a compound C,
right? Yeah.
So that's the knowledge because people have done that, and you know, that information is given to you. That's your knowledge. But when you do the practical learning, right, then the moment when you go and start doing it, then you start asking questions. If you are a curiosity driven person, like say like why only compound A and compound B,
right? Yeah.
If I add instead of compound B something else, what will happen?
Mm-hmm.
Right. And or you will say like, you know, why you're adding like a say X amount of compound A, Y amount of compound B, if I add something more than that, what will happen? Right. So these are the things when you're doing practicals, actually you're putting your thoughts into mind. And if you're a child like where you know, curiosity overtakes you, you start trying to find out these things and do yourself and find out what is the outcome.
Yeah, now taking this very interesting point, you say the curiosity, I would like to understand from your own experience, like you studied from a school like any other child would be studying. You also have gone to college, which most of you would have been told to choose a college and go forward. But how was this transition from the knowledge to the research movement, and when was this and how did it happen?
Yes, it did some extent. For example, during my school days, okay, to be honest, like I'll tell you, like I didn't like education much.
Okay.
Till I completed my BSc.
That's interesting.
Yeah, because my always focus was like, I think till 8th standard or so, I was interested in education, going to school. But after that, somehow I changed my perspective. I always wanted to become an entrepreneur, businessman.
Now, what was the trigger stopping before I would like to listen further?
Okay.
I would like to understand. There was a trigger, you said that no, you were not very happy with something which was happening. And what was that not happening, right? And your trigger was there?
I think what I vividly remember is it's nothing to do with the school.
Okay.
But rather, I think at 8th standard, one of my friend introduced me to a library.
Oh,
okay. Okay. Where I started reading fiction novels. Okay, I read like I think at least 400 to 500 novels I read.
Wow,
in my
a
school,
huge number, 400 to 500.
Yeah, school days to college, that's the number I read. So that's how I used to bunk schools and go there.
Okay.
So there are like some of the writers like very inspirational books I read. For example, like writers like Endamuri Virendranath, Suryadeva Ramon Rao. These are famous Telugu novelists.
Right.
So some of their novels, they used to say like, you know, about like a person like focusing on business, how right from the scratch to build empires. Okay, I think that is the time like it got so excited for me to like, you know, it's not about creating wealth at that time, but rather going through obstacles and crossing obstacles and, you know, building new empires right from the scratch. I think that was the journey of their. Although it's fiction at that time, but that used to inspire me so much. So then I'd come back into school, and if I do at that time, all I study is like what is there in the classroom, right? So with little knowledge, no knowledge at that time, right? So I couldn't connect dots, thinking from this knowledge given in the school, how I can create other one.
Right.
I saw that disconnect.
Uh-huh.
There is no practical examples to show that. So I thought of this can be done only through these businesses.
Mm-hmm.
So that's where like I tried my best to, you know, stop my education and go for businesses. So that's how that was the trigger point, if I say.
Okay.
So
now this is a very interesting trigger point. I'm sure somebody allowed you to continue having this trigger point. So you started from a town like Mehbub Nagar, right?
Absolutely.
Which is now in the part of Telangana.
Yeah.
And making it to an IISc Bangalore, and then moving to an New York, and then moving to an Harvard Medical College. So how do you see a small boy sitting in one library and trying to become, you know, moving to an Harvard Medical College? So how do you see this happening?
So it's an interesting thought you have put it, like because although if you see like my college days, and now what I do, although it looks like a poles apart, very different, but I can tell you like it's strongly influenced by those events what I am today.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a strong correlation today. I'll give you an example.
Right.
So as I mentioned, like during college and all, I was so much excited about doing business, entrepreneurship. That's what used to excite me. That's why I used to, you know, trying to stop my education, go full time as an entrepreneur. But like various events, I had to come back to education and do the full time. But if you step back and or fast forward 20 years, today if you see me, I can call myself as a science entrepreneur.
Mm-hmm.
So because I do like a very high standard science research, basic research we do in the laboratory, but the technology is what we develop. So we, after that, we practice entrepreneurship to take these technologies, convert them into a product to reach to the people.
Wonderful.
Right?
Beautiful.
So that entire entrepreneurship now I do. So practically I'm living my dream of my teenager. Right? So that's why I say like these are all connected. I think if I didn't have that thought process at that time, probably, I'm not sure whether I would be doing as a science entrepreneur today. I might have been a regular scientist, completely focused on lab work. I would have been ended up in that way. Probably, not sure.
Yeah. I'm sure it's very enticing for children and educators to realize that this is, you might start somewhere, but you also have a possibility of going to much higher in your life. And I'm sure this is going to be inspiration for people too, even who are sitting in a smaller town across in India at the moment, that they know that there is a possibility of making to an university like Harvard and or University of Science Bangalore and various other institutions in the future, and contribute back to the society system and be an entrepreneur of area of which you love it, in the form of, it could be a scientist in that area of it, or it could be a businessman in the area of it.